Okay, guys, in this sample project, we are going to create a HDR for this part of our project, or you can apply this setting in any project you have. Okay, so there is no problem in this part. Okay, but most of our works in this video is in out of Revit. So first step, you need to download this great software, which is called Street View Download 360. You can download it for Windows or Mac, and then you need to install it very easily. And after that, you need to go to the Google Map website and find the place you want to get an HDRI for that place. For example, in here, I'm going to create a HDRI for this place that I found for this Street View. But the tip here, what you need to know that if that place you are looking for that doesn't have any Street View or a Street View map, you can't create these kind of images, and you need to use some ready-to-use images. Or for that purpose, you can use some panorama editors and take some pictures from the site and combine them together in those kind of application. But that's not the topic here. You need to copy this address here, and then you need to go to the software. Let me bring it down. You need to go to the software here, and then in here you need to go to the tools tab and paste the URL here. You will get an ID here. You need to select this ID and then go to the panorama download. Choose the location you want to save it and give it a name. It's not really important. For example, new final. Press enter and then paste the panorama ID. And you can download it with different resolutions. If you want to get a better experience or better quality, or if you want to resize it after in some softwares like pro version of this software, or for example panorama editor, you need to download it in a bigger resolution. For example, I want this resolution, and then click on download panorama and you are good to go. And you need to wait a little bit to get the panorama you want. You need you can see it's downloading the tiles here, and then you can use it in your Enscape project. But it is I put the title for Enscape, but you can use it in any software that that support HDR image. For example, you can use it in Blender, you can use it in Lumion, you can use it in D5 render, or any other kind of software like your Unreal Engine and so on. After finishing the download process, you will have the panorama here. You can open it, and also you can view it in some other 360 viewer. For example, in here we have a 360 viewer. We can click on it. And also in here, we can open it in 360 viewer. And also you can watch it in VR and zoom in and zoom out. And then you can download it very easily, and you can download it again. For example, let me save it again with a smaller zoom, for example, to final. And that's great. Let's go to the Revit project, and I've opened the Enscape here. In the sample project, you need to go to the visual setting here in sky tab. In here you need to change it on a skybox, and then you will have some setting for it. And also we have another video for HDRIs in Enscape. We've talked more details about the settings there. You can check it out, and that will complete this process for you, and you can use HDRIs efficiently in your project. Let's go and change this once to a new HDRI that we exported from there. Let me search final here. I think we haven't saved that, so there is no problem. I'm going to choose this one. Click on open and wait a little bit, and Enscape will update the HDRI for you, and then you can apply other settings that we've discussed in HDRI video in HDRI pictures in Enscape, and you can check the settings there. You need to wait a little bit to see the updates. Now you can see the updates here. As I said, it depends on your project, so you need to find a good place that fits to your project. For example, in this view, it can be good, but if you would render from here, that can be a bad panorama. So it's not usable for every view, so you need to find a nice view and angle for your panorama and for your panorama picture to get a nice render. For example, you can rotate this one, for example, to here. You can change the brightness and other settings here. You can see the other video to see to know more about these kind of settings.